keep checking now and then to see if I can speed up, and it's just not doing it automatically. But you'd see a flash of light as well. I just want it to speed up. It'd be really nice if it did. But no! We can't have that. It's almost like a water vapor. Like from a rainfall, like not rainfall, waterfall. But there is no waterfall. Going the right way, right? Yeah, we were going up the whole way. The whole time, rather. It's starting to rain heavier. It's coming down pretty well. Are those words over there? I think they are. I wish you could run faster. So come back and then make a left onto the path. I think they are. Yeah, I could start to see little letters. I wasn't sure. There is no fabric of time that will let you keep listening to my sounds. You cannot just give an opportunity to anyone who follows you secretly. Yeah, that was... The window of time to let you listen to my sounds, that part was... Of course they were all from the first Drizzlepath game. But it was also on the red path. Look at that, there's a house up there. Looks like a very tall house, with many floors.
One day, he caught me playing too close to the big water wheel. He took me by the hand and sat me down on a recently hewn stump. Sitting across from me, he said,
"It's in the air."
"I know you, Lula." In a soft, soothing voice, sounding not at all mad. "You are the weaver's child. I see you running and exploring like no other. You have an inquisitive mind, and that's good. We are not so very different, you and I."
Oh, wow. That's the water wheel we're talking about, but that house is in the air. And so the path goes... Path goes not this way, apparently. Ooh. What is, like, fire? It's, like, sparking, too. Huh. Okay, I guess we go this way. Good to know. Hopefully they didn't miss anything back there on the road. If he did, it was smaller than that huge house in midair. That sped us up again. Shortcut.
The people say you are mad. They are afraid of your machines, I said. His brow furrowed as he looked towards the village center where people were going about their daily business. In hushed tones, he said, do you know what the people are really afraid of, truly deep down?
Anything different from
they
them.
Are afraid of learning their true nature.
Oh, maybe.
They fear the truth about what they are.
Yeah, that too.
He looked back to me as a nearby machine stopped working and looked towards us. It seemed to be listening.
So the machines can look and listen. Snow-capped mountains.
Is this the wrong way?
I hope not.
You see, Lula, the
Let's
miller continued.
Find them.
They are afraid that the machines may one day develop their own intelligence and begin to make their own decisions. That they will, in a way, be just as alive as them. This frightens them because it would prove their notions about life to be wrong. It would mean that life is not magic, but a natural, inevitable occurrence of sufficient time and conditions. A light seemed to glow in his eyes as they pierced deep into my own.
Mm-hmm. So talking about androids, possibly?
What they are really afraid of is that the reflection they see in the mirror is also just a machine. A wonderful biological mechanism, but a machine nonetheless. They think themselves free, but in their willful ignorance, they are as free as guinea pigs in the maze. Their life is out of balance. He let out a long sigh and said, now, be on your way, Lula. The machines grow restless without work to do. He stood and began to walk away, then paused and looked back at me. Stay curious, Lula, child of the weaver. Never stop exploring. Never give up hope. find the genie, and most importantly, question everything.
Question everything. So, apparently, the machines have their own rudimentary intelligence anyway, right? Because they can grow restless. And then again, even animals can grow restless, but animals have an intelligence to them. But are they sentient? That would be the difference.
Question everything. His admonition echoes in my sleep and weaves its way into my dreams. Dreams that the shamans say are proof of the gods. Could they be wrong? Will the machines learn to dream? If they become free to make their own choices, to choose their own path, will they be good choices? Will they be kind? It all sounds so absurd. Surely there is not enough time in all the world for them to develop intelligence.
Yeah, but don't call me Shirley. Slow down. I don't want to slow down, Danny. This reminds me of the title, at least, of Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep? This is definitely the less interesting path. It's just like, it seems like there's more just nothingness between everything than this
perhaps
red path.
Perhaps the miller was mad after all.
Oh yeah.
The stories of the shaman seem much simpler and easier to understand. Is it wrong to question what you are taught? Will it make me also mad if I question everything? If I doubt the stories told by the shamans, surely they will think me mad. And worse, they may think I am wicked. But I know in my heart that I am not. So perhaps it would be best not to question the shamans. They are the wisest of our people and surely can't be wrong.
Anybody can be wrong. The knife is hidden in the shadows and the Templar is in the island of the donkeys. A big black cloud is darkening the already blackened sky with a new suicidal trend. I remember the island of the donkeys being mentioned. It was one of the things I could make out from that voice. I don't like that it was a step down. I just wanted to go straight down. Are there more words over there? Oh, just some sparkly stuff, maybe. Oh. Oh. actually scared me. That was loud. Okay, we got some platforming.
Can't find Genie by just walking.
Right, meaning also we jump. Oh! Damn you! I got too sure of myself with that last one. I just wanted to hop straight across. Oh! Really? Maybe I'm not supposed to go for that side. I didn't have any trouble with the red path platforming. It's just that side looked closer.
Machines had grown their own intelligence and built their own village, a shiny little town of dwarves.
Machine dwarves?
They busied themselves with building and making a place of their own in the world. But where were the people? As I wondered, a tiny machine with huge spectacles appeared before me. Instantly, I saw what had happened to all the people. I saw a plaque on a dry shoreline amidst smoldering ruins. It said, "We were here. It can't really be said that we did the best we could."
Why didn't they do the best they could? If I go down there, I won't be able to get back up. But the blue stuff is over there. Down there anyway. Let's head back to the path and we'll make a left. Can we climb back up? There's really nothing around here. Mm. Yeah, we can make it back. We just bypass the rocks. Mm.
As I walk, I wonder what I will find at the top of the Mountain of Fire. I have only heard of the genie in stories and have never seen it myself. I feel awe, and with it, more than a little fear. Can there be reverence without fear? Awe without mystery? We seek answers but resist them when they threaten the notions we feel. Often, we prefer to dwell in the dreams of the heart than in the truth of the mind. The genie has power. This much I know.
She also said the same thing in Red Path. Checking now and then for more words. I know I'm probably only finding like half of them.
Life, out of balance. I remember the Miller's words. Is it our nature to think ourselves somehow separate from all other things? We do seem to perceive in extremes, light or dark, good or bad, happy or sad. When we follow any extreme path, life falls out of balance and we become grotesque caricatures of ourselves. Inside, we become like a pregnant goblin, forever travailing, but never giving birth. Empty vessels obsessed with fullness.
A pregnant goblin? Okay, you're getting strange again. You're going funny again. Imagine how drenched me must be by now. It's like if we could become any more wetter, we'd turn into water itself. The house.
Perhaps our true nature is neither extreme. Path and a life in balance is the middle path. But where is this middle path? I have not seen or heard it. Though I cry out, hello, in the unpopulated wilds, I seem to be alone. I want to give an opportunity to someone who has followed me secretly. A chance to walk with me. But it seems unlikely as chickens that swim for anyone to change the path they have chosen.
Books. We got the books here. When you open windows. Oh, more words. Yay. Hello. You remember yourself sealing the crooked window shut, but not why you did it. You enjoy your freedom the same way a guinea pig enjoys his maze. I remember that part. And I remember, hello! Sounded like a different voice when that happened. Again, referring to the events or the dialogue from the first Drizzlepath. So we go up that way, and then we go... What ends here, does it? This ends here, alright. I thought it was, there was like two ways to go again. Not used to a path just going up to the house and then stopping. Although I think it did that once before. Maybe we're getting higher, close to the top of this mountain finally. Don't fall off. Statue up there? Is that the genie? I think that the genie is that big.
I dreamed of a brightly colored carnival that came to the village. A dark storm threatened on the horizon, and the winds battered the tents and streamers. A hawker in a top hat cried out from a grandstand, "Come one, come all, test your wits and guile in the house of mystery. Adventure or horror, it is up to you. A game of $60 for the majestic audience." Lines of people with blank eyes, starved wide, filed in slow procession into the tent.
Like zombies. Where'd the music go? Oh, don't fall. I wonder if there's some kind of time limit or something like that. Because you're supposed to beat the wizard to the top. And I backtrack back and forth a few times. I don't know if that makes a difference.
There are those who simply never choose a path. They know that neither extreme is balanced, but they cannot find the middle path, and so they become frozen in a stasis of indecision. Distracted by anything and following the whims of the day, they seek to fill the emptiness with any passing fancy. They too seek the genie, but they do not know why, and so become lost. Even with unmoving eyes they see me. They would eat me alive if they could.
Yeah, that kind of made me nervous that we came across that before. Same statues, just in a different area. And the same quote, but we had, like, I think we had, like, kind of unnerving music playing at the time as well. Now there's just nothing. Are we going into another cave? I'm just passing underneath this. Where's my music? There we go.
Though I have not seen much life along this path, I look for
the dragon.
I thought I saw a stag out the corner of my eye, fleet-footed into the forest. Or perhaps it was just a memory rising to the surface. I remember walking idly through the forest one day, simply enjoying the green scent of the air and the singing of the birds, when my idol was disrupted by a crashing through the trees.
Yeah, that isn't a stag. That is a dragon. At this point, I'm sure I'll be sighting it shortly. I don't think we have anything to worry about with the dragon. Just nothing happened on the red path. Oh, that's new.
It was a stag that seemed frightened and injured, as its legs buckled beneath it. And it fell to the ground at my feet. I could see that it was shot through with an arrow. I recognized the work of the Fletcher from our village. His shot was not true, and I wondered how far the stag had run before collapsing. How long had his fear and pain been drawn out? His chest heaved with struggling breath. He fought to breathe his last.
That's sad. Ooh, I just thought that lightning was gonna hit the dragon.